but it all started when the officers approached that suspect's vehicle, because that's when the suspect stepped on the gas, dragging an officer from Zone 5 down the street. He had to do everything he could to get that suspect to stop and for himself to survive. James Jordan cleans up the bricks, mud, and broken glass from where the suspect crashed here on Stanton Avenue.
I heard a big bang. Then I sound like I heard two shots, and that's what scared me.
Shots fired from the officer, police say in self-defense, just seconds before the suspect crashed into the porch of this apartment building, where inside this woman and her husband were watching TV.
The entire floor of our building just like shook, and we heard like boom, and it was almost like an earthquake type feeling. And so my husband and I jump up because we're like, this isn't part of the show. This is like real outside.
Real indeed. Outside, a sea of police canvassing the area and taping the road off. It started with a traffic stop. As two officers approached the vehicle, one on either side, the suspect hit the gas, dragging the officer on the passenger side an entire block. That's when he jumped inside.
And the officer believed at the time that his life was in danger, and so he took this action. He tried to physically take the gear shift and move it. He made efforts, whatever efforts he could, to stop the vehicle.
But even that didn't slow the suspect, who police say started fighting until the officer grabbed his service weapon and started firing in self-defense, causing the driver to lose control. Neighbors are grateful an innocent person was not hurt.
It scares me, you know what I mean? I mean, what are you going to do? Think of somebody who's walking past here. Right. Me, you, or somebody else. Just walking past with kids or something. They don't think about that.
That officer had injuries to his hand and his arm, but he's expected to be okay. As for the suspect, he underwent surgery early this morning for gunshot wounds, last listed in serious condition. Police are waiting to charge him until they get a chance to talk to him and the officer. Right now, their names are not being released. We're live outside Pittsburgh Police Headquarters. I'm Amber Dekotra, Channel 4 Action News.
All right, thanks, Amber.